It's another Tuesday night edition of Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network.
That's very impressive because those are the best of the best.
Me growing up, hearing about racing, that's kind of all I heard about is the Van Pelt. So to have Billy drive my car was pretty good deal.
You're not just buying a racetrack, you're buying a piece of American racing history right there. I mean, that's huge. The history behind the track, mind-boggling.
Race fans, it's time to throw it up on the cushion and get dirty. Live from the Casa de Porkchop Studios, it's time for Turn 5 Live. Now, your hosts of Turn 5 Live, Stephen Ovens, Clint Miller, and Brad Ovens.
Hello, race fans. Welcome to this week's episode of Turn 5 Live. Not quite Turn 5 Live this week. We're coming to you from the Gory Racing Benefit Party happening here. This is coming to you from Saturday night out here at the Seneca Falls Elks Lodge. Master of Ceremonies here, Nick Guerri joining us here first on the program tonight. Nick, fantastic turnout, as always, for you guys. This is going to give you guys a great start to the season.
Yeah, this is going to be awesome. I knew it was going to be big, moving it back a week from Volusia and all the modified guys being here, and it just exceeded expectations. There's a lot of people here, so it's going to be an awesome kickoff to our season.
Definitely. How many years have you guys been doing this here?
This has gone, the last couple of years we've had here, I think we've had four parties here, but the annual Guerri Race Party has gone back. I mean, Paul's been racing 20 years, so it's been close to that since we've had a party. So every year since then, even with Paul, we had parties.
Takes a lot of work to put something like this on. You got to have, all these people donating prizes and, how many pounds of meatballs do you guys make the other night?
We had 70 pounds of meatballs last night, 40 pounds of ziti. Just an awesome all-out family-oriented meal. I have to give it to my aunt and uncle, Steve and Michelle. Those guys, let us use their house, their kitchen.
Absolutely.
Aunt Michelle took work off of Friday just to get things started and worked all day today. And my cousins, my mom, dad,
I saw pictures on social media. You guys were, that was a big crowd, rolling meatballs.
Yeah, it was huge. It's like a, a yearly thing that we do now, an annual meatball rolling session we have the night before the party. But I mean, it's all in good fun, and we appreciate the help everyone gives us and everyone that donated prizes. We couldn't do raffles without them, so I appreciate all the businesses that help out.
We talked to you on Turn 5 Live the other night talking about the new chassis, getting things going. How far off from being ready are you guys right now?
We're pretty close. Just waiting on a couple things to button up and a few parts I need to get to finish up. And the last week or so, we dedicated that time toward the party to get everything, rounded up and make sure we had a good turnout here. So starting tomorrow, it's back to business, getting that car done. Hopefully over the next week or so, we can get everything buttoned up. We're in pretty good shape.
Cool. Now, let's talk about some of the partners you guys got coming on this year. I know that Pampered Parents was one that stepped up real big for you guys this year.
Yeah, Pampered Parents has been great. They started out last year and just as associate sponsor, and they stepped up, took the main sponsor on the quarter panel this year. So I'd like to thank Patricia Page and her group. They've been great, and they just stepped up and sponsored a night up at Canandaigua.
So. I was going to say, so not only with you guys as a team, but they take that next step to activate the sponsorship by being at the racetrack.
Yeah, absolutely. And Patricia's great. She helps our team, and she's an awesome woman to work for too, because her employees love her, and she puts it all on the line and lets those guys have a good time, brings them out to the track. So it was awesome. A few more people I'd like to mention: Gevo's Rears and Gears, Yukon Gear and Axle, Macedon Parts Plus, Mike Welch, Crate Motor Connection, helped us out with a new engine this year, Trout's Auto Recycling, just everyone that helps out. It's a big team effort, and I appreciate the help that those guys give us.
And for those that may not have caught our episode this past week, Canandaigua Weekly, and then looking over the schedule to see how many grit races you can catch.
Yeah, absolutely. And one person I left out, one of our most important sponsors, Paul Cole, Champion Power Supply, Super Gen Products. Paul was just here, and Paul's came on in a big way and helped our team out, as well as the track. I know he's helping out Blackrock, Canandaigua, our team, Mark Minutlo, the Ruggles, Mike Welch. So just a great guy all around, so I'd like to thank Paul Cole. But as far as the schedule, back to Canandaigua Weekly. We're not going to miss a show there. Grit Series, we're going to hit the North region. And I need to sit down. I'd like to hit the Upstate Sportsman Alliance and then take a look at the South dates and see what we can put together. And if we can work out some dates to hit both Grit Series, I'd like to go for the championship overall.
Okay.
But I'd also run I'd like to try out for the Alliance deal too. So I'll have to sit down and weigh our options and see what tracks we're better at and see how we can do it.
There's a lot of good things for sportsman guys in 2015. I mean, you have Grit Series, you've got the USA, along with all the weekly competition. I mean, this is probably one of the bigger years for Sportsman Modifieds than we've seen in a long time.
Yeah, I've been racing 8 years in Sportsman now. This will be our eighth season, and I mean, it's been the biggest so far. I mean, there's good paying races all over the place. And, every track has them. The rules are, pretty much uniformed other than, the tire deal at a couple tracks. But, overall, it's just great to be in a Sportsman. I mean, you can go anywhere and race. I mean, you could race, you don't even have to have a weekly track. You could just race specials only or, foul series or whatever you wanted to do. It's awesome for us.
Well, talk about this crowd here tonight. This is a who's who of dirt track racing here tonight. Even if you just looked at the Sportsman guys that are here. I just saw Casey Pavlik was here, Fran Hilton, and, of course, all the guys from Canandaigua as well.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. I mean, like you said, Fran Hilton, Casey Pavlik, Doug Smith, Bubba Burnell, Eric Jaguar, Kevin Ridley, Ray Hendershot, Kenny Banker, that owns a car at Canandaigua. And we have the full Fender guys, Mike Welch, Mark Minutlo, my cousins have a Cure Stock. And the modified guys, Justin Harris, Gary Tompkins, Matt Shepard, Mike Mahaney should be here. It's awesome that those guys come out and support their fellow racers and have a good time.
I was going to say, for a guy that runs in the Sportsman division, it's got to make you feel good to see some of these modified guys come out and support you guys at your benefit parties and things like that.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome. And it just carries through to the season, too. I mean, a lot of people don't see behind the scenes, but anytime you need a hand or a used part or need to borrow this or that or you need a used tire because you can't get a new one that week, those guys are always willing to lend a hand or, set up knowledge or, anything. Being on the Grit Series or some tracks we didn't hit, we've never been there before, and, we walked into Penn Can, didn't know anything about the track, and Gary Tompkins was parked a few rows down from us. So, he got us ballpark what we needed to do for tires and things like that. So, I mean, they're all here to support us, but they're also here all year long.
I saw that Gary was a guy, too, that kind of was able to give some guidance up at Syracuse, being that last October was your first run on the mile.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Gary shared a shop with us a few years back, and our friendship still continued, and like you said, at Syracuse, Gary was always willing to come over and chat. I mean, we didn't call him, we didn't ask for help. He was just there with his knowledge and offered it up for us to take, so I appreciate that.
Let's look ahead to this year. What's it going to take for you guys to take that next step? I mean, you guys are right on the cusp of being able to take wins weekly, and you've got the top fives and top tens behind you. Is the new chassis one of those steps toward making that push forward?
Yeah, I really hope so. I mean, every season, you need some luck, but we need some consistency. I know there's a few times throughout the year last year we got in a little slump and, had 10th, 11th, 12th place runs. And I mean, to run the Canada, you can't have 10th, 11th, 12th place runs and come out with a championship. You need to have wins. You need to have top fives. So consistent top fives, top threes is what we're looking for. So just maintenance, tire prep, just being on top of our game, ready to go every show.
And not for nothing else too, but Canandaigua was one of the tougher fields around.
Yeah, that's the hardest track we've ever raced at. I mean, there's times that I'd rather go to a Penn Can or a Black Rock or some place that I don't run much or I've never been before at all. We usually seem to fare better at those tracks than we do at our home track on Saturdays because the competition's so stiff. I mean, there's people in the division like my Uncle Paul and Steve Gray and Eric Jaguar. Those guys have been in the class for years. And,
yeah.
I mean, they run you clean, and it's hard to beat them, so you got to be on top of your game to get it done.
And not only is the competition level tough at Canandaigua, the track is always a bear to get a hold of, and not in a bad way. I mean, it is probably one of the racier tracks that you guys get to see on a yearly basis.
Yeah, it definitely is. I mean, Canandaigua's not a track that you can just, hug the tires around the bottom and stay there for 25 laps and win. I mean, your car has to be, it has to be balanced, and you got to be able to move top, bottom, middle. The track changes a lot from heats to features. You know, sometimes we're after the modified, sometimes before. So you really got to keep an eye on the track and, you know, keep watching up at that fence to see what the track's looking like to make changes to your car.
Got a lot of plans for 2015. What are some of the realistic goals right now?
More wins is always the goal. We ended up with 2 wins last year. I'd really like to, you know, 4 or 5 wins, I think, would be a more realistic goal for us. At Canandaigua, I think we can get it done. We had, you know, a parts failure coming out of 4 leading the race one time. That would have been another win for us. Another time we ran a close second. So 4 or 5 wins at Canandaigua would be fantastic for us. I'd like to get out on the road in the Grit Series and win. We've had a, you know, a whole bunch of seconds. You know,
I was going to say, you've been close so many times.
Yeah, all over the place. We just need to get done on the road. I mean, and the competition's great there, and it'd be awesome to be on top at another track.
Well, man, you got a fantastic crowd on hand here tonight, and appreciate you inviting us out to come out and do some interviews and participate here, and wish you a lot of luck in 2015.
Well, thank you very much, Steve. And, you know, thank you guys for the awesome DJ service here at Creekside. You guys are doing a fantastic job, and thank you, Turn 5, for what you do for us racers.
Absolutely. That's Nick Guerri, master of ceremonies here at the Guerri Racing Party. We're going to take a quick pause for the cause. After this break, we've got more interviews here from the Guerri Racing Benefit. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag. But drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Ever higher, never quit. Lofty goals in this age of shoddy quality, corporate indifference, and built-in obsolescence. It's a beacon of light in a crowded field of mediocrity. The way a company is run is an indication of how you, the customer, is going to be treated. You have a lot of choices when you're searching for auto and performance parts online and at the corner parts store. So why should you buy from Excelsior Racing? Because they're simply the best online parts supplier in the business. If you're looking for selection, ease of ordering, cost, and prompt delivery, look no further. If you have a question, our customer service hotline, staffed by knowledgeable gearheads like you, will ensure that you get what you need to fix or mod your car or truck. With 1,000 suppliers, you're guaranteed to get what you need. First time, every time. Excelsior Racing. Excellence on the track. Excellence on the road. Excellence in customer service. Online at ExcelsiorRacing.com or call 502-909-2034.
For 17 years, Stock Car Steel has been a leading material supplier to the racing industry. Now they're also an official motorsports content partner of Race Chaser Online. The biggest names in NASCAR trust Stock Car Steel for all their raw materials, such as carbon steel, chrome moly, DOM, aluminum, plastics, and much, much more. You can't build a race car without the basic materials, and Stock Car Steel is the place to get them. Don't forget to also visit Stock Car Steel's sister company, SRI Supplies, for racing and industry. SRI is your number one source for all your shop supply needs. Nuts, bolts, rivets, tapes, adhesives, cutting tools, chemicals, body shop supplies, paint shop supplies, lubricants, and more. A well-stocked race shop is a winning race shop, and the road to winning begins with 3 letters, SRI. For more information, visit StockCarSteel.com and SRI-Supplies.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Stock Car Steel and Aluminum, or call either company toll-free at 1-888-752-7272.
Proving that raw talent isn't a necessity to do mobile radio, let's get back to Stephen, Clint, and Brad.
Welcome back, race fans, here to Turn 5 Live, here on the Performance Motorsports Network, coming to you from the Guary Racing Benefit Party here in Seneca Falls, New York, here at the Seneca Falls Elks Lodge. Now we're going to get a chance to talk to the G-Man, Paul Guary, driver of the 7 car. Paul, thanks for joining us here. It's quite a big event for you guys. Got great turnout and people having a good time out here.
Yeah, that's what it's all about. We have this party every year, and we get a lot of support, and I think this is our biggest party we've ever had, so I want to thank everybody for coming out.
Now, how long have Nick told me that, you know, I mean, obviously, you've got a lot more experience in the racing deal here, but how long have you guys been doing a party like this?
I've been having a party, I think I've had one since I started, you know, 3 or 4 years after I started racing. I started in 91, so
okay,
probably mid-90s.
Yeah.
We started out having little parties, and we all started racing, and now we got this big turnout now.
Now, talk about, you know, a party like this, putting on the benefit, gives you guys a really good start to the season, you know, financially, getting the team going, getting out on the track for the first couple weeks.
This helps out a lot. This time of year, you know, we're trying to get the cars together, and every dollar we get helps, and it's tough because, you know, we're trying to rush. Now, you know, we got a month to go, and
yeah,
trying to get these cars together, so this really helps out pretty good.
Now, you're going to be coming out with a brand new Troyer. Just took delivery of it here, a month ago, or maybe a little more than a month ago. How's that coming along so far?
It's coming along pretty good. Just got the motor, new engine yesterday.
Okay.
So that's ready to go in. We should be ready to go probably a couple weeks here or so.
Okay.
JR Graphics, PDG Graphics has a body over there, so I'll go pick up that. And probably a couple weeks we'll be ready to go.
As far as color scheme, anything major changes there?
Yeah, I'm sticking with a yellow body this year. And
okay.
I got a purple chassis.
So okay.
We're going to go with purple and yellow, and, you know, I don't know what he's going to do. He does his magic every year, and I never question him, so
okay.
I think there's going to be a little black on it and some fluorescent red, and he does pretty good every year. I never question him.
I've always wondered, you know, how drivers handle that. You know, I feel like some drivers probably take it to him and say, all right, this is specifically what I want, and then other guys say, you're the professional, you do your thing.
I just brought the body over there, and I kind of thought I wanted to stick with a flat black number, and we just tell them where the sponsors go, where we want them located on the car, and they pretty much do whatever they want with colors and stuff. And it's, you know, it's pretty exciting going to pick the car up because we don't know what it's going to look like. And
exactly.
It's pretty cool to go pick it up, and you're excited when you get it.
You know, the other thing, you were talking about graphics. The other thing that I feel like I've seen more of this year than I've ever seen is guys picking up new suits. I know you were one that picked up a brand new suit and gonna look good along with that race car.
Yeah, another Velocita suit. They do pretty good work. They help us out every year, and I kind of grew out of the other one, so I had to get a new one. So they treat us pretty good, Brad at Velocita.
Cool. Looking ahead, Canandaigua's going to have a regular show prior to that big 64 lapper the next weekend. 64 laps at Canandaigua, that's going to be a tough one for guys. What's going to be, you know, in your past experience, have you guys run long distances like that before?
The most we've ever ran in a Sportsman, I believe, is a 50 lapper maybe. So
okay,
you know, we're going to have to, you know, enough fuel to figure out our fuel and everything, and
yeah,
you know, it's going to be 64 laps, but I'm sure there's going to be a lot of cautions and stuff, so we're going to have to really do our homework, and
yeah,
it's going to be different. It's going to be fun.
How about tires? What do you expect in tire wear is going to be like that night?
I'm thinking it shouldn't be too bad because it's, you know, track should be still tacky, and, you know, usually at the beginning of the year is tacky, and tire wear is not too bad, but like you said, we've never ran a 64 lapper, so
yeah,
this is all going to be new to all of us.
Plus, you've got the modifieds are also running a long distance race that night. I'm sure that there's got to be some consideration there as well.
Yeah, depending on when our feature is going to be, it could be real slick for us, or it could be really tacky, or, you know, it's going to be up in the air what it's going to be like with all this snow we got on the ground now.
Talk about the, you know, Jeremy with his track prep at Canandaigua. I mean, I feel like the more we talk to drivers that run at Canandaigua, the more they seem to be pleased with the track prep. It's racy. They can move around if they need to. And sometimes in order to win, that's what you got to do is move around.
I got to give Jeremy a lot of credit. That track's the best it's been. And probably, you know, since he's been there, it's been, you know, it hasn't been that good in probably 10 years, 12 years.
Yeah.
He really, you know, takes pride in what his track surface is like. And it's pretty good. He does takes his time with it, and he's always got a fast racetrack, and it's usually, you know, three lanes, you know, top, bottom, middle.
Yeah.
And he does good work on that track.
Is there anything from the driver's standpoint, is there anything you guys see specifically that he does that makes that track so racy?
I don't know how he does it. I don't know.
I mean, it's probably one of those, if he told us, he'd have to kill us kind of
you
thing.
Know, one thing he does is he changes the feature order every week.
Okay.
So when we go into the track, we don't know if we're going to have our features first, last, second, third.
Yeah.
So that's kind of, you know, tough to set your car up when you don't know when your features are going to be. We know when we get to the track is when we find out when the features are going to be.
Right. So I imagine with that being said, you guys, you know, if you guys, your features later on in the night, I imagine you guys got to keep an eye on that track all night long to see what it's doing.
Oh, yeah. If we're after the modifieds, then we got to go with our slick setup. If we're before the modified, depend, you know, then they got the sprint cars.
Right.
I guess we just got to see when we get there.
Yeah.
How everything goes. And it's pretty cool how he does that, though.
Yeah. 2015, coming out with a 2015 Troyer. Have you ever come out of the box with a brand new piece in the past?
Last year's car was new, and 2012 when I got the Troyer car in 2012, that one was a new one. But this one is it's totally different. It's the big block car we're going to try with the Sportsman motor, the
yeah.
Great motor. So it's up in the air. We don't know. It should be good. We're thinking it's going to be good. We're hoping it's going to be good. So
yeah.
I guess only time will tell.
Does Billy and the guys at Troyer, do they give you guys kind of a, this is what we think it's going to do for you, or?
Yeah, they, you know, they tell us this is what, you know, the car should be good. This is the setups we'd like you to try. And,
okay.
You know, try this, try that, because this is all new to them, too.
Right.
You know, the small block car that I used to have, that was the crate engine car that we ran, the small
yeah.
block car. Now we're putting these in the big block chassis, so
yeah,
we're hoping it's going to be good.
Yeah. What's the major difference between that small block car you talked about and the bit? Is it just the engine compartment? Is it
The engine on these cars are 2 inches back towards the back of the car.
Okay.
These cars have rubber floors in them, which the small block cars didn't.
Okay.
And fuel cells are located in a different position, and the batteries and, you know, just a few of the components are located in different, you know, areas.
Which, you know, with the different location for all those items, I mean, that's going to play an effect on your setup for sure.
Oh, yeah, it's all going to, you know, even the driver, how the driver sits in the car. We're lower in the car. With the small block car, we're up in the air, you
okay.
know, up higher. So everything with those cars, it seemed like everything was up. Now with these cars, we're going back to having everything down.
Yeah. Well, man, I wish you a lot of luck. I know that you guys are expecting big things this year, coming out with the new cars. And, you know, you get a lot of good feature finishes in there and might even get something out of that Troyer Cup.
Oh, we're hoping to get that. You know, I'm thinking I'm going to do a little more traveling this year. I want to hit some of the grit series.
Yeah.
It's kind of been tough the last couple of years, you know, kids with sporting and sporting
yeah.
events and, you know, going camping. And I might just try to take this year and, you know, instead of going camping on a weekend, go racing for a weekend. And
sure.
We'll see where it goes from there.
Is there any place that you're thinking of off the top of your head that's a place I'd like to go visit this year? Any track in particular?
Utica Rome, you know, it seems like a good one. Maybe Ransomville and Rolling Wheels, whatever they got going. I've always liked Rolling Wheels.
Yeah.
It's always been a fast, it's one of my favorite tracks, Rolling Wheels, but we'll see what happens there. You know, Weedsport with their deal going on, so.
Yeah.
We're going to try to hit, you know, quite a few more tracks this year.
It's going to be a lot easier for you guys to go to Utica Rome now that they're on the Hoosier rubber, so.
That makes it a lot easier. You know, that's one of the reasons why it was tough to do the try to do the grit last year. We had Hoosiers mounted up last year. And,
yeah.
And then you want to go race, you got to mount American Racers up. And,
yeah.
It was kind of tough, you know, with the, you know, getting home from work 7 o'clock at night, and then you try to scramble to get everything done. So
yeah.
I got a lot of help this year, you know, crew. We talked, and we're going to try to do a little more traveling, so we'll see how that works out.
Cool. Well, man, we wish you a lot of luck. I appreciate your time stopping by, and just a great event you guys got going tonight.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
All right, that's the G-Man, Paul Guerri. Here at the Guerri Racing Benefit Party, we're going to take a quick pause for the cause. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag. But drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See jasperengines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Ever higher, never quit. Lofty goals in this age of shoddy quality, corporate indifference, and built-in obsolescence. It's a beacon of light in a crowded field of mediocrity. The way a company is run is an indication of how you, the customer, is going to be treated. You have a lot of choices when you're searching for auto and performance parts online and at the corner parts store. So why should you buy from Excelsior Racing? Because they're simply the best online parts supplier in the business. If you're looking for selection, ease of ordering, cost, and prompt delivery, look no further. If you have a question, our customer service hotline, staffed by knowledgeable gearheads like you, will ensure that you get what you need to fix or mod your car or truck. With 1,000 suppliers, you're guaranteed to get what you need, first time, every time. Excelsior Racing, excellence on the track, excellence on the road, excellence in customer service. Online at ExcelsiorRacing.com or call 502-909-2034.
For 17 years, Stock Car Steel has been a leading material supplier to the racing industry. Now they're also an official motorsports content partner of Race Chaser Online. The biggest names in NASCAR trust Stock Car Steel for all their raw materials, such as carbon steel, chrome moly, DOM, aluminum, plastics, and much, much more. You can't build a race car without the basic materials, and Stock Car Steel is the place to get them. Don't forget to also visit Stock Car Steel's sister company, SRI Supplies, for racing and industry. SRI is your number one source for all your shop supply needs. Nuts, bolts, rivets, tapes, adhesives, cutting tools, chemicals, body shop supplies, paint shop supplies, lubricants, and more. A well-stocked race shop is a winning race shop, and the road to winning begins with three letters, SRI. For more information, visit StockCarSteel.com and SRI-Supplies.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Stock Car Steel and Aluminum, or call either company toll-free at 1-888-752-7272.
Welcome back to Turn 5 Live. Here's Stephen, Clint, and Brad.
All right, race fans, welcome back to Turn 5 Live here in the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Guerri Racing Benefit Party here at the Seneca Falls Elks Lodge in Seneca Falls, New York. Going to get a chance to sit down with Matt Guerri, driver of the 12G Crate Sportsman over at the Canandaigua Motorsports Park. Matt, welcome to the show. Big event you guys got here tonight.
Yeah, it's great. A lot of good friends, sponsors. It's a good time, family.
Yeah. You guys have
not only, you know, family, friends, you got competitors from almost every division at Canandaigua here tonight. So
yeah, it's great. It's good to see other sports and drivers come out, modified drivers, a lot of drivers from Canandaigua come out and have a good time with us.
Talk to us about, I mean, I talked to Nick, I talked to Paul. You know, Paul said they've been doing parties like this as long as, you know, 3 or 4 years after he got into racing. I imagine that growing up as a kid, you've got to have memories of coming to these parties for as long as they've been doing them.
Yeah, I mean, Paul's been racing, it seems like, forever. He's always had race parties, and we're always coming to help him out. And then me and Nick got going racing, and he's like, you know what? We'll all just have a race party together, and everybody we know, and
yeah,
have a good time together. So it's,
show me another sport.
I mean, this gets you guys off to a great start, you know, financially, get the team going. I mean, those guys, they're bringing out the Troyer pieces. You've got your Bicknell. Talk to me about, you know, what you've done with the Bicknell over the winter to get it ready for the season.
Yeah, we updated a bunch of parts. We got new shocks and exhaust. A lot of things that we needed to update from last year. We got the same car. We got 09 Bicknell. I loved the car last year. Handled awesome. I was impressed with it.
Yeah.
So we stepped up. We updated a lot of parts this year. Steven was out west. You know, my brother, my uncle, Kevin, they all got the new Troyers. They all have new crate motors. And
yeah,
we're on the 3-year-old crate.
So y'all need to give every one of you.
I'm pretty confident. It'll hang. Hopefully, it'll hang with you.
And what's different about this year, too, is now you're going to be able to take your notebook with the Bicknell. And now you're going to have two cars to use, because now Frank has got the Bicknell, too. He sold his TO, updated to the Bicknell. Talk about, you know, how that's going to help both of you guys this year.
Yeah, I mean, he's got fortunately, he has Kevin Ridley's old car, and that's the same exact chassis I have. The 09 rubber floor, driver back, everything's the same as what I have. So we can take our notes, repair them during the year, and just put our heads together and try to make ourselves better from that. So, I mean, it's better than going out and having your own opinion compared to someone going out and having their same chassis has their opinion, too. So
absolutely. A couple guys have talked to me about the rubber floor. Explain to me what does it mean by when the guy says, you know, this chassis's got the rubber floor.
Right under where you sit in the floor in the car, you sit in the center of the car. They got it's like four mounts where the slider goes for the torque arm to hook to the rear end. There's four small oval rubber mounts where the floor connects together, and supposedly it gives you more flex in the corner and gives you more side bite and forward bite. So,
gotcha.
I'm not sure if I notice a difference compared to running a regular car, because I've only been running for 2 years, but someone with more experience probably can notice a difference. But I ran a 2011 Bicknell, regular floor. I ran a rubber floor last year, noticed quite a big difference.
Cool. I was just talking to Paul about, you know, the fact that, you know, Canandaigua is one of the toughest tracks around here as far as sportsman competition goes. Talk about how much you've learned, how much experience you've gained running with that top competition every week.
I mean, Canandaigua has, if you ask me, they got the top sportsman drivers around in New York State.
And yeah,
it gets frustrating sometimes. You're running against guys who ran for 30 years in the sportsman class, and then getting a top 10 there is like getting a win somewhere. I mean, it's tough running against guys like Paul and Eric and Steve Gray. They've been running for a long time, and it's hard to beat them, but it gets frustrating. But also on the other end, you go to a different track where the competition isn't that strong, and it shows how much you like improved yourself running against some of that competition every week, and then going somewhere that doesn't have that competition.
Especially when you guys travel. I mean, you guys have done some traveling. Talk about where you were out to last year.
We stuck to Canandaigua every Saturday last year. My job didn't allow me to travel too much. I worked nights, and it's tough to go.
Were you down at Woodhall, or was Nick in the car that night?
Nick actually drove my car at Woodhall.
Oh, okay. That's what I was thinking of.
Yeah,
okay.
He had his car ready for Syracuse, so
he
wanted to make the grit race, so I told him he could take mine. So I had to work nights, so it's tough for me to go to week shows during the week and take work off. So this year might be a little different story, so I'm not on the nights anymore, so I might be able to hit a lot more shows, hopefully follow a lot of the grit series.
Yeah.
they put a lot of good shows together, so hopefully we can hit a lot of them races.
That's probably something that, you know, race fans that go to the racetrack on Saturday nights, maybe they don't think about, is, you know, a lot of these guys, you know, we've all got jobs to pay the light bill, you know, and you know, not everybody, you know, works Monday through Friday. They might work evenings, they might work night shift, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
But, you know, doing all that stuff, that's why we get to go to, you know, that's why we get to go to the race on the weekend. So, you know, I wanted to ask you about, you know, I see you for this year, you've got some involvement with, I can't remember if it was HBR specifically or if it was Moha or what. Talk to me about that.
I've been helping Matt Shepard the last couple of years in the series, and I talked to Al Hankey, and they came on board this year with Mohawk Northeast and helped me get started, and they stepped up big time. And for someone like me in the sportsman division, that means a lot. It's hard for someone like me to just got started to go out and get new sponsors. So it was a big help for them guys. I mean, them guys are awesome over there. They help me with everything. Every question I have, they answer, and they're always there to help no matter what it is. I mean, if I have any problems, they're always willing to come down to the shop and help out. So they stepped up big time this year and helped me out.
The financial part is always a help, but I have to imagine that you can't even put a price tag on being able to get those questions answered. And, I mean, Matt has quite a bit of experience running the Bicknell car, so I got to imagine that that's something you can't put a price tag on.
Oh, definitely. I mean, going with them guys, I ask a lot of questions. We go to the track, and I try to pick his brain as much as I can. He's won a ton of races in every division that he's ran in, so he might get annoyed sometimes, but every little thing, I like to ask questions and pick his brain and ask why he's doing that and just try to learn as much as I can, because you guys have a lot of knowledge and obviously know what they're doing.
I think I asked Nick this question, and I'll ask you, what is the goal for this season, or what would, you know, at what level is it, you know, X number wins, top fives, top tens would be a successful season this year?
I mean, to me, I like to be competitive. I just want to be, that's great.
We've got all sorts of friends here tonight, don't we?
To me, I want to get in victory lane at least once. I mean, we ran competitive last year. We had a ton of top fives, seconds all over the place, and just need to go that extra step to get to victory lane and get the monkey off our back, really.
Yeah, I'm sure the party would not end till the morning.
Yeah,
if that 12G parked it in victory lane this year, I know you've got a great crew of marketing partners that are helping you this year. I'm gonna give you a chance to talk about those folks.
Yeah, definitely. Danny Camara to Camara Slate, he helps me out a ton. I mean, anything I ask, he's there for me, no matter what it is. Mohawk Northeast, Dale Hankey, I mean, as we talked, they came on board this year. Yeah. We got Gevo's Rears and Gears, Massen Parts Plus, we got Champion Power Equipment, Paul Cole, he's great for us, he does a lot of stuff
he's
for us.
He's a fantastic supporter of racing.
Yep, he's a great addition this year. He just came on board with us, so trying to make sure I didn't leave anyone out. We got Sicilian Contracting, Daryl Nutting. He's actually a competitor of mine.
Right.
And he actually came on board. He helped me out too. So it's actually
that's a unique situation there.
Someone I race against helped me out with sponsorship. So it's pretty cool that he does that. Every little bit helps, and it's great that he does that for me.
No doubt about it. Well, man, go out and enjoy yourself tonight. We've got Duke Syracuse on the big screen, and going to be giving away a ton of great prizes here. Well, thank you for your time.
That's cool. Thanks for having me.
All right. That's Matt Guerri, driver of the 12G. We, on the other side of the break here, we're going to talk to some more sportsman drivers. And for the end of the show, we'll even get some modified guys in here. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at winyournewcar.com. That's right, winyournewcar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free, delivered to your door. Come on, stop dreaming and start driving with winyournewcar.com.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies, the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
So you finally arrived at the sweet spot in your life. The kids are raised and gone. You have free time, and it's finally time to do something for you. If you've ever considered owning a Corvette but have been putting it off for years, now is the time to act. Isn't this the time to finally get that Corvette you always wanted and drooled and dreamed over? Well, grab the little lady by the hand and take her to Cooper Corvettes. They're conveniently located on Route 1 just off of I-95 and just north of the Marine Corps base. They have lots of pampered and well-maintained Corvettes in inventory, and if they don't have what you want, they'll find it. From classic Stingrays to modern-day cars, Cooper is your one-stop shop. And speaking of shops, they service what they sell. And even if you didn't buy a Cooper Corvette, they'll service your Corvette anyway. Become part of the Cooper Corvette family. Call them at 703-445-1483. That's 703-445-1483. And on the web at coopercorvettes.com. That's coopercorvettes.com, American pride and countrywide.
You wouldn't trust your taxes to an uncertified accountant. So why trust your vehicle to an uncertified technician? When you have to take your car into the shop, look for the blue and white ASE sign. That ASE blue seal means the shop employs technicians certified by the National Institute for Automotive Service Excellence. ASE certification is proof that technicians have the knowledge and experience to fix your vehicle right the first time. For more information on finding an ASE blue seal of excellence facility, visit the website at www.ase.com.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ and photo booth of Turn 5 Live. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are sure to provide you with the very best DJ and photo booth entertainment on the market in the Finger Lakes. Call Stu at 315-481-9700 or creeksideentertainmentdj.com. Book your party or photo booth with Creekside Entertainment today.
Now back to the crew whose studio was named after a dinner entree. Here's Stephen, Clint, and Brad.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here in the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Guerri Racing Benefit Party here at the Seneca Falls Elks Lodge in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get a chance to talk to the cranker, driver of the 113 Junior, Frank Guerri. Junior, welcome to the program, man. It's been a while since we had you on.
Yeah, it has. Thanks for having me.
Hey, man, talk to us about, you know, this benefit here. You've got your benefit coming up next Saturday. You know, I've asked all three of the guys I've had on so far just how important an event like this is for you guys to get the season started.
It's really big for me. You know, I don't have a ton of sponsorship out behind me, but just financially helps you get a start on the season, carries you through it. It's a real big deal. It's awesome to have everybody's support come out. You know, it gives you a good feeling getting into the season here. And, you know, I just can't believe the turnout here. There's a ton of people.
Yeah.
It's definitely awesome to see modified guys and shoe stock and pro stock guys here. Everybody.
I was talking to Paul about, you know, they've been doing parties like this, you know, as long as he's been racing, you know, 3 or 4 years that he was running. You know, they started the parties, and I have to imagine that as a younger kid, you've got memories of a little kid coming to the party every year.
Oh, absolutely. You know, we definitely look forward to it. You know, being underage and stuff, snag a 30-pack off the table, go have a couple drinks. It, absolutely, you know. And we started having them, I think it was around 2009 or 10 when we came back from the street stock racing.
Yeah.
We started having them. We've been having them every year since. It's just a huge help, you know, and the support means a ton getting into the beginning of the season. You know.
Now, 2015, sold the TO, picked up a Bicknell, and as I recall, I believe it's Kevin Ridley's old Bicknell, right?
Oh, yeah. It's one Kevin had there for a couple of years. He actually took a little bit of a wild ride in it, but, you know, we've checked it all over, gone through the whole thing, and the car's good to go. Got rid of the T-bolt, got a little more room in this one being a driver back, and it's got the rubber floor.
Yeah.
You know, so we sold everything that went on the deal also. So yeah. You know, we've upgraded as much as we could, you know, with our budget allowing us. And I'm really pumped and really, really looking forward to this year.
So we've got updated chassis, updated pieces to go on the chassis, and oh, by the way, a $10 crate motor that you won last weekend.
Absolutely. You know, that was a huge deal for our team, you know, being low budget. And, you know, we haven't decided what we're going to do with the old crate motor yet. We might just sit there for insurance.
Sure.
You know, because blowing a motor, in my case, that would definitely sideline us for a while. But, you know, the Grit guys, I can't thank them enough. And Craig from Crate Motor Connections, what an awesome deal.
Yeah.
You know, we went up there with Nick and everybody. You know, I participated in, I think, two, maybe three Grit races.
Right.
And,
we are going to start.
You know,
raffle.
We went up to have a good time. You know, racing go karts with the drivers, support Nick. And it was a great time, you know. And I only bought one ticket because I never have any luck.
Sure.
You know, and getting donating it at a time like this is like, hey, I got to get the car together too. So
right.
That was just absolutely huge. Blue, you know, I can't say enough about the Grit Series, everything they're doing. And, you know, to get guys come to the shows and the giveaways and everything they have every race. It's just absolutely huge. And it definitely makes a low-budget guy like me want to go to as many as I can.
Sure.
You know, because you never know what you're going to walk away from a Grit Series race with.
Right.
These guys are just absolutely awesome, and what they're doing is great for the drivers, and can't thank them guys enough.
You know, it also goes to prove that it only takes one ticket, right?
Absolutely. You know, that's the funny part, too, is just one ticket. But, you know, I never win anything, so.
Well, now we don't have to say that anymore.
Absolutely. So I guess it paid off and got something big out of it.
We talked here, I'm going to say it was a month or so ago, as far as, you know, what you're looking toward this year. And at that point, you know, you had said, you know, Steve, I'm thinking about a little mix of, you know, Black Rock, Canandaigua. Is that still kind of where you're at right now?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I can tell you this. I will be at all the Weed Sport shows. I love that place.
Yeah.
I always got around there good in a full Fender car.
All right.
And I love being there. Ready? So I'm going to do all those.
First day.
And I think to start the year, we're going to try to do mainly Black Rock and Canandaigua and maybe see where we're heading and doing a little better and maybe take it from there. But it'd be awful hard to get me away from Canandaigua on a Saturday night and be part of that back row gang.
Oh, absolutely.
The support from our family and everybody is just tremendous.
You get your choice, you know, off
so
of the
it's
table.
It's definitely not easy to get away from there.
I mean, that's really a family tradition, you know. You know, Dad's raced there. The whole family's raced there. So I'm sure that would be a tough deal to try and go away from that.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I raced there in pro stock when I first came into the full Fender class, I think for 3 years, and I love the place and just having everybody support and, you know, bouncing ideas off of Kevin Ridley or Nick or Paul, Matt, anybody, you know, and everybody being there to help you if something happens too, you know, the support is just huge and it's tough to get away from that. So I can't say I'm going to commit to Black Rock, but I definitely have a lot of fun racing down there, and if I don't race there every week, I'm going to get there as much as I can, you know?
Yeah. You and Gibbs, Matt, are both going to be in the Bicknells this year. It's got to make you have a little bit more confidence knowing that you guys are going to have a notebook to share off of from two cars, you know?
Yeah, absolutely, you know, and the way Gibbsy went last year, I might just want to do everything he's doing right off the bat. You know, he was on fire, had a great year. He didn't get that win, but he was so close so many times, and, you know, he's really come a long way just last year, it seemed like. And, so, you know, and being Kevin's car, he's got a notebook still, you know, so between them two, I'm not worried about the chassis change and getting into a big cow or anything. Like I said, Phil's got all this stuff in his head pretty much, you know, and being Kevin's car and knowing what Kevin did, you know, and he'll help me out with any issues and Gibbs too, so.
Let's, looking ahead to 2015, what in your mind is it a number of you know, wins, top fives, top tens, it's going to be a successful season for you?
I really don't know. Obviously, we go to the track wanting to win every week. So that, you know, I can't say I'm going to go measure my season on the amount of wins I have. I'm looking to be competitive. That's my biggest thing. And last year, it really would get me down at times. I could start up front and I could hang with them guys for 10, 15 laps, but it just seemed like the later parts of the races, they just drive right by me, you know. So I just want to be competitive, and be able to start in the back and drive up front, you know. And I know that's not the easiest place to be going and doing anything.
True.
You know, you look at some of these other guys, the competition-wise and what these guys have, you know, Nick and Paul and Kevin all got new chassis. I heard a bunch of other drivers also got new chassis with good stuff. And the talent wise, you know, you're green doing something ticket. If you're starting in the back or running the top five up there. I'm not definitely want to win, but I'm not going to measure my season on wins. So
yeah. Well, man, you can't do it without a great crew and good marketing next partners ticket. Behind you, and I want to give you a chance to talk about those folks.
Yeah, we had Siri Sand and Gravel come back, Superior Crushing, Tyler Siri. I can't thank him enough for everything he's done. Trout's Automotive, Recycling, Gevo's Rears and Gears, Massen Parts Plus, Morrow's Trucking Equipment, Madskins came aboard this year, going to help us out. And do what they can. Pilots drew us up a design, going to do something a little different, so I got to thank him also. I think that's pretty much it.
Cool.
Sponsorship wise, and I really got to thank my wife, my daughter, my mom and dad. I want to send a huge thank you out to Kevin Ridley, Nick, and Matt, and Phil. And Paul, them guys, I don't know if they really understand how much I appreciate all the help they're giving me. And, you know, sometimes it's just even emotional. I'll get down on myself, and they're like, hey, we've all been there. Give it time, you'll get it. So, and even in the shop, Kevin's helped me out a ton, and I really want to thank them guys. You know, it means the world to have them support me. So I'm really looking forward to a fun and successful 2015 season with all these guys helping me out.
Oh man, I'm sure that with that crew and the equipment that you've got, and the experience behind you guys are going to have a good season. And we appreciate you taking some time to talk to us about it.
No problem. I appreciate you having me. I got a question for you.
Yes, sir.
When are we going to see you back in a car?
Careful now.
Come on.
Well, I'll tell you what. I think I'm starting to get myself busy enough where I wouldn't even have time to do it now. But, definitely something I think about, you know. It's been since 2003, I think, and that was the last time we had the four-cylinder.
So it's been long enough.
It's been long enough, yeah.
Okay, so there's definitely got to be somebody out there that needs to put Steve Ovens in their car for one night.
I'll be honest with you. I actually have had an offer from a four-cylinder guy. And, we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens.
We're going to have to talk to Stuart.
But I'm going
to
be up in the announcing booth, so, I got to take care of business.
Technology is wonderful. You could get that right in the helmet.
That's true. That's true.
All right, buddy. I appreciate it. Thank you very
man.
Much.
Good having Frankie on the show here. And we've got to plug the benefit next week.
Yeah, it's at the SMS Club, March 7th, starts at 6 o'clock. There's beer, raffles. We're going to do something a little different. We're doing chicken barbecue.
Oh, nice.
With brisket. And we got some salad, baked beans, and all that stuff going on. So we're looking to have a good time and hopefully a great turnout.
I'm telling you, I've played Frankie's benefit last couple of years, and if you leave and you're hungry, it's your own damn fault.
Absolutely, and that's another person I really got to thank too, is my buddy Brian Updike. He's doing the food for us for the benefit, and helped me out here, and Blowing Smoke Barbecue. So I definitely want to thank Brian.
Well, that's going to be next Saturday, March 7th, 6 o'clock, there at the SMS Club, Seneca Falls.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Well, Frankie, thanks for your time, and we're going to get some more interviews here right on the other side of the break. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at winyournewcar.com. That's right, winyournewcar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free, delivered to your door. Come on, stop dreaming and start driving with winyournewcar.com.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies, the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
So you finally arrived at the sweet spot in your life. The kids are raised and gone. You have free time, and it's finally time to do something for you. If you've ever considered owning a Corvette but have been putting it off for years, now is the time to act. Isn't this the time to finally get that Corvette you always wanted and drooled and dreamed over? Well, grab the little lady by the hand and take her to Cooper Corvettes. They're conveniently located on Route 1 just off of I-95 and just north of the Marine Corps base. They have lots of pampered and well-maintained Corvettes in inventory, and if they don't have what you want, they'll find it. From classic Stingrays to modern-day cars, Cooper is your one-stop shop. And speaking of shops, they service what they sell. And even if you didn't buy a Cooper Corvette, they'll service your Corvette anyway. Become part of the Cooper Corvette family. Call them at 703-445-1483. That's 703-445-1483. And on the web at coopercorvettes.com. That's coopercorvettes.com, American pride and countrywide.
You wouldn't trust your taxes to an uncertified accountant. So why trust your vehicle to an uncertified technician? When you have to take your car into the shop, look for the blue and white ASE sign. That ASE blue seal means the shop employs technicians certified by the National Institute for Automotive Service Excellence. ASE certification is proof that technicians have the knowledge and experience to fix your vehicle right the first time. For more information on finding an ASE blue seal of excellence facility, visit the website at www.ase.com.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ and photo booth of Turn 5 Live. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are sure to provide you with the very best DJ and photo booth entertainment on the market in the Finger Lakes. Call Stu at 315-481-9700 or creeksideentertainmentdj.com. Book your party or photo booth with Creekside Entertainment today.
This is Rich Sharpstein, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here at the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Guerri Racing Benefit Party here at the Seneca Falls Elks Lodge in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get a chance to talk to a driver moving up to the modified ranks this year, Andrew Ferguson. Andrew, pleasure to have you on the show for the first time here.
Yeah, pleasure being here. I wasn't expecting to be up here getting a podcast with you. It's pretty cool.
We're grabbing people left and right best we can here. And actually, I mean, we, Brad and Clint and I that do the show weekly, had mentioned you as a guy that we want to catch up with, and it was just perfect that you were here tonight because we wanted to talk to you about moving up to the modifieds this year. Prior to this year, give us a little bit of your racing background. Some of the folks that I think listen to our show probably haven't been introduced to you before, so give us a little bit of your background.
Yeah, sure. I raced Syracuse Mike Rod Club when I started that when I was 6. I raced there till I was 18, and then I moved up to novice sportsman's at Fulton in 2008 and ran that for a few years, crate class. And then 2 years ago, made the jump to open sportsman's, ran down the southern tier, ventured up to Utica a lot last year. And then, you know, this year we decided to make the jump, had some really good partners that came on, my work, Fusillo Nissan, and A lot of good opportunities arose, so you know we figured, why not? You know, give it a chance.
You guys have had a couple years in that open sportsman, and it's just that natural progression to want to move up. Was it you know sponsorship support that allowed you to make that jump, or is it just it's time for us to do this?
Well, absolutely. I mean, I think it's a little bit of both. Obviously, you know, you can't do it without either the talent or the money. You got to have both, and I'd like to think that, you know, we've proven ourselves in lower levels. You know, we haven't accomplished everything that we've wanted to do, but I just think the timing is good. You know, we're at a position now where we have enough partners and great partners, and I have enough help, and we're just in a position to do it. And, you know, you never know if you're ever going to get this chance again. You know, being, you know, I'm 23, going to be 24 this year. I'm young. You never know when you're ever going to get a chance like this again. And so I'm just really excited to live it, you know.
Yeah.
It's been my dream since I was young. My uncle, John Barker Jr., I watched him for years in the outlaw circuit. And it was always just something I always wanted to do, and just happy to be living the dream.
So where are you going to be running this year? Do you guys have tracks picked out yet?
Yeah, we're going to be doing Brewerton on Fridays and Utica on Sundays. It's going to be a lot nicer to have that day in between to do a lot of prep and, you know, maybe venture down, watch some racing for once. I don't get to get out and actually watch much racing anymore. The race car takes up a lot of time, and which is fine. You know, that's what you pay to do, and but I think that having that extra day in between, being just me and my dad and a few small people, you know, help out, it's going to be the best fit for us.
Yeah. I imagine that it's also easier for guys, you know, running, you know, if you ran Brewerton on Friday, now Utica Rome's moved to the Hoosiers. Now you don't have to dismount, remount a bunch of tires to go race at Utica.
Well, exactly. You know, that was the other thing that made us switch. The original plan was Brewerton-Fulton.
Okay.
You know, kind of with Fusillo being in Clay there, right down the road from Brewerton, that was kind of a must.
Yeah.
The local support, local advertisement. So that was a big deal. And then the second night was really left up to the team and myself to pick which night we wanted to do. And once Utica kind of switched, it was kind of with my laps there last year, and I feel like we really came on strong midway through the year until we had some misfortunes that shortened our year last year. But I feel like we were going to a point where we were really getting the track down and getting the place down, so I'd really like to continue that into the modified division. And I feel like Brewerton and Utica are the two places I'm going to learn the most.
Yeah.
I mean, modified country up here. It's
stout fields.
Yeah,
both, you know.
They are. And, you know, you're only going to get better by the field, people you surround yourself with. And, you know, I mean, you know, Matt Shepard and Stuart Friesen, Larry White, all those guys, you know, you can't shake a stick at them. You know, I mean, it's a real honor to be able to do this, and I'm really excited to do it, and I just can't wait to get rolling. I need the snow to melt so we can get going.
I'm with you on that. And you know, you talk about running Brewerton, you know, right down the road from the Clay dealership. I mean, that just follows something that, you know, you've heard people in racing talk about before. Win on Friday, win on Saturday, win on Sunday, sell on Monday, you know?
Right.
And I imagine that's kind of what you guys are looking at, you know?
Well, that's exactly what we're looking at. You know, I mean, obviously we're in it to race, but, you know, you can't do this without great partners, unfortunately. I don't come from a family with a lot of money. You know, we do this. It's really funny. My dad and I were talking the other day about it's a funny story to look back 10 years ago racing mic rods where you're like, man, I'd really like to get you a right rear tire this week, bud, but I can't afford it. And tires were $30, you know, and you look at where you are now, and, you know, like I said, you can't do it without people helping, you know. I got Mike Mahaney on that helps me out a lot with a lot of stuff, shock work, and if I need any parts, this guy's got it. You know, they're really good to me. Brian Donath and Sean Donath Motorworks, they give me the greatest deals I can get, you know, and you know, other people stepped up. Chris Hiles helped me out a lot this year with the move, you know, confidence stuff. Just people coming on, even if it's not materialistic stuff, it's not money or it's not parts. It's just confidence, people giving you tips, giving you different things to get you heading in the right direction. Every bit helps.
That's, you know, things like that. Those are the kind of things that you can't really put a price on.
Right, exactly. You know, I couldn't have said it better myself. And I'm just really blessed to have people like that around me.
Now, you talk about, you know, coming up from the Syracuse Quarter Midget Club. I mean, there's been some pretty good names that have come out of there over the years.
Regan Smith came from a mic rod. You know what I'm saying? He's NASCAR, national level, you know. A lot of people. I believe Kevin Ridley raced there.
Okay. Tranca.
Joe Tranca raced there. Andrew Shartner, runner to Oswego, he came from there. I raced with him. We were best friends growing up.
Nice. Just got his first track championship.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, doing really well. He's flying up from North Carolina every week, and couldn't happen to a better family, honestly. But there's a lot of good talent. This sport needs that. It needs young people, and I mean that's the other thing that I think this is the move I'm trying to make. I hope I inspire other people to do what they can to move. I mean, the sportsman class is growing, and they're getting a lot of good entry-level people in, and we need this sport to grow, you know? Yeah. I mean, it's a long shot to make it national level, you know? So we need to, you know, support your local racetrack, get out, and live your dream, you know? I mean, that's what I'm doing, and I'm just blessed to do that.
It seems like this offseason we've had more positive momentum than in any other offseason I can remember in the last 5 to 10 years. I'm interested in your perspective on that as a driver, guy fielding one of these cars every week.
Well, you know, I see for the first time, you know, just in my situation, Utica switching to the tires, joining around local teams. All the tracks kind of getting on the same rules for guys, and you know, a lot of tracks starting to let the crate sportsmen's come in and paying them money to come. You know, I mean, when I race crate sportsmen's, you know, I think you got $30 to take the green. You know, I mean, and your pit pass was $30,
right?
You know, it's a really good thing. The sport is, I think, going in the right direction. You know, if this rolling wheels thing works out, I mean, that is looking like it might be a good thing for drivers. You know. I don't know. You know, Bill and Kim Shea are taking over at Utica. I think, you know, they're going to do good. They're racers. And, you know, Brewerton and Fulton are also nice places. And I enjoyed racing in the Southern Tier. I enjoyed racing at Skyline Raceway. And I ran 5 Mile a couple times, Thunder Mountain a couple times. Nice tracks down there, good racing. It's just I feel like this sport's going in the right direction. You know, and I agree with you. It's been a more positive off season. Like I said, just a lot of big races coming up this year for a lot of different classes. And that's what you need.
You know, you do.
You're not going to get people to bring their cars out of the stable if they ain't worth their while. You know, I mean, your fun can only go so far. You know, you can't go and lose $500 a night every single time you go.
Exactly.
You're not going to get people to go.
I mean, you're not going to get rich off this sport, but the best you can, you know, the more you can do to at least work toward breaking even or making a little bit, you know, that's a huge deal these days.
Exactly. You know, I mean, it's down to having fun. We do this to have fun. I mean, at least I do. If I have a good night and make some money and I'm able to, you know, put some tires on the thing next week and not have to strain my bank account too much, then that's a plus. You know, no one's in it to become rich around here, which is, it's, you know, that's what it is.
Yeah. Talk about the equipment, motors. You mentioned Donath Motorworks. What kind of chassis are you guys running this year?
We just bought a new Higfab.
Okay.
2015 Higfab. Jerry Higby's been really good to me. Rutt and all them guys down there give me a lot of cool information. Car's just about done. Graphics are getting done at PDG, JR. Jimmy Ryer's doing them, and the design looks really cool. I can't wait to show it off at the show. I think it's going to be a really nice-looking car, and you know, it's all new. Car's all new. We're doing this move right. That was the point of us wanting to do it. We sold a lot of stuff, bargained with a lot of stuff, made a lot of trades to get the things we needed to go and do it right the right way.
Yeah.
You know, so, I mean, a lot of it's going to be on me. I got an engine from Donath. It was Chris Hiles' backup engine last year. He had a few laps on it, so we just had it checked over. We're going to get that. And, makes good numbers. It runs good, and really good piece, really stout piece. So we're just trying to put as many positive pieces together so that it's less of a problem on me. You know, a lot of it's – I just want to go out there with the best piece I can get and just get seat time.
Yeah.
I don't want to – I just didn't want to waste a year saying, like, man, you know – I probably could have used a chassis. You know, my chassis is 6 years old. You know, I probably would have went better with a chassis. You know, so we're going to go out there with, you know, all our ducks in a row for probably the first time ever. We got everything lined up, and thankfully we got partners to help us get that done, and that's important. So
Higfab, you know, it seems to be one of the up-and-coming chassis for the modifieds. what is it that made you guys want to make that? Did you have any seat time in a Hig Fab, or you guys just like what you heard talking with them? How did that work?
Yeah, no, I don't have any seat time in them. I've had Bicknells my whole racing modified career. And, when it came down to the point when I wanted to move, I was just kind of looking around, and I seen a lot of them running really well. Not a lot of them up here. Brewerton, Fulton, you know, they don't have a lot of cars up here. I think Willie Decker's got them.
Yeah.
Steve Payne had them and had some decent runs this year, you know. And Mike Bowman got one at the end of the year at Brewerton and had some really good showings. And I never had any issues with Bicknell. They were always really good to me. I just wanted to try something else.
Yeah.
And Jerry has a lot to offer. He can do anything you want. I mean, if you want to try something off the wall and mix, you know, if you want to mix some crazy stuff in, he'll do it. He doesn't care, you know, and he wants that because he wants the feedback, and he's eager to grow and eager to get his stuff going in the right direction, you know. I mean, I last time I talked to him, I think he was going to have over 50 cars this year. He might be more than that now, but
wow,
that's huge.
Yeah.
I mean, if you've ever been there, it's this little place out in Goshen, and you know, he's got this little, I think he said it was 60 by 100 garage.
Yeah.
That he's got all these great guys working out of, and they're just building killer product. You know, it's a really beautiful piece. I got it home, and everything bolted on. All my Bicknell stuff bolted right on it.
Cool.
And I didn't have any issues with it. The body work is the craftsmanship is just great. I mean, they're all to that level now. And I'm just excited because you got somebody that you can get on the phone with. You know,
yeah.
I mean, the only problem I had with Bicknell a lot is that Randy Williamson, he's so busy.
Yeah.
You know, he's got a lot of cars. They're pushing a lot of cars, and which is great for them. But,
right,
you know, a little guy like me has sometimes trouble getting on the phone with him, you know, and Jerry's not like that. I don't have that issue with him yet, you know.
Right.
When he's building 150 cars a year, maybe I will. But
I've heard of Jerry taking phone calls in the middle of the night when he was racing himself.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah,
you know,
oh, yeah, yeah. I mean, Ryan Jordan kind of turned me on to it. He was running down the Southern Tier, and he used to race Mike Rods with me too. And he switched to him last year, and he just was like, "Listen, man, you can't find anybody that's better." You know, right, call him at the racetrack or text him. He'll get back to you and be like, "Hey, man, you know, what do you got on for shocks? Or what are you running for a tire compound? You know, I don't have a lot of laps there, but tell me something. Maybe I can come up with something." You know, that's what you need.
Yeah.
And I guess Utica Rome he's going to have their open practice day. I guess he's going to have a driving school / chassis seminar.
Oh, okay.
Jerry is. So that'll be cool for me to go to and hit up and, you know, just – I need to be a sponge this year. That's what I need to be. So I need to surround myself with people like that that are eager to help, and we're just really excited about it.
Well, it sounds like you guys are certainly doing things the right way, and give you a chance to talk about all those good people behind you this year.
Oh, God, there's so many of them. I always forget them, and I apologize if I do. But first and foremost, my mom and dad and my girlfriend, Becca, they without them, they're the support system. You know, they got to stand behind me, and if I'm going to the track by myself every week, it wouldn't be worth it, you know. Fusillo Nissan, obviously, Billy Fusillo Jr., one of the best guys I know, one of the best guys to work for. Great company, and, you know, he's come on board big for us. Acura Refrigeration, Napa Auto Parts, they come on big for us. Valvoline supplies all our oil and stuff like that, which is a big help. Warner's Auto Body, KLS Auto and Cycle. You know, like I said, there's so many people. Donath Motorworks, Mike Mahaney Racing Shocks, Chris Heil, you know, all them guys. Scott Jeffrey at Gypsum, he helps me out a lot, turns me on to some stuff that, you know, trying to help me make this move as easy as it can be. And
he's had some success over the years.
Yeah, I would say, you know, I would say. So it's good to have people like that in your corner.
Yeah. Well, man, we wish you a lot of luck making the move. We'll certainly see you up there to Utica Rome a few times. And, hey, man, go get them. I mean, you guys are loaded for bear, so go get them.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the cards are, you know, stacked the way they are. I'm just kind of hoping we can get out there and get some seat time and hopefully just, you know, if good finishes come, I hope that comes. But really just looking to make this move and live my dream, man, you know. And thanks for having me on. And
absolutely.
I appreciate it. And hopefully I won some raffles at this party.
Yeah,
you know?
There you go.
That's some cool stuff. But thanks a lot, man. I appreciate it.
All right. Well, that's Andrew Ferguson. He's moving up to the big blocks this year.
out at Brewerton and Utica Rome, stopping by to talk to us about the jump this year. And we'll have more here from the Gregory Racing Party right after this. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
Hi, this is Jens Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag. But drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Ever higher, never quit. Lofty goals in this age of shoddy quality, corporate indifference, and built-in obsolescence. It's a beacon of light in a crowded field of mediocrity. The way a company is run is an indication of how you, the customer, is going to be treated. You have a lot of choices when you're searching for auto and performance parts online and at the corner parts store. So why should you buy from Excelsior Racing? Because they're simply the best online parts supplier in the business. If you're looking for selection, ease of ordering, cost, and prompt delivery, look no further. If you have a question, our customer service hotline, staffed by knowledgeable gearheads like you, will ensure that you get what you need to fix or mod your car or truck. With 1,000 suppliers, you're guaranteed to get what you need. First time, every time. Excelsior Racing. Excellence on the track. Excellence on the road. Excellence in customer service. Online at ExcelsiorRacing.com or call 502-909-2034.
For 17 years, Stock Car Steel has been a leading material supplier to the racing industry. Now they're also an official motorsports content partner of Race Chaser Online. The biggest names in NASCAR trust Stock Car Steel for all their raw materials, such as carbon steel, chrome moly, DOM, aluminum, plastics, and much, much more. You can't build a race car without the basic materials, and Stock Car Steel is the place to get them. Don't forget to also visit Stock Car Steel's sister company, SRI Supplies, for racing and industry. SRI is your number one source for all your shop supply needs. Nuts, bolts, rivets, tapes, adhesives, cutting tools, chemicals, body shop supplies, paint shop supplies, lubricants, and more. A well-stocked race shop is a winning race shop, and the road to winning begins with three letters, SRI. For more information, visit StockCarSteel.com and SRI-Supplies.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Stock Car Steel and Aluminum, or call either company toll-free at 1-888-752-7272.
Proving that raw talent isn't a necessity to do mobile radio, let's get back to Steve, Clint, and Brad.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Nick Gwary Racing Benefit Party here out in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get a chance to talk to a gentleman that we've never had on the show before, but happy to have Mike Mahaney on the show. Mike, welcome to Turn 5 Live here. Not quite our live show, but doing a little pre-recording here for Tuesday night. But, man, talk about this event. Huge crowd out here tonight.
Well, good to be here. Thanks for having me on. You know, it's a great event. Glad to support Nick Gwary and all the Gwarys for their racing efforts. They're big supporters of me with Mike Mahaney Racing Shocks. They all run my equipment, and they run really well at Canandaigua Speedway and when they travel around. And really proud of them.
Let's start there. Let's talk about the Racing Shock business. How did you get started in that?
Well, probably started out when I went to college. I went to Alfred State University for motorsports technology. Got a little base knowledge there, and went to Race 101 school, and Tony Blanchard gave me a lot of knowledge and shocks there, and kind of took that and ran with it. Bought myself a shock dyno, and then got
just got more experience and tried different brands and trial and error just got me to where I could learn a lot. And you learn a lot when you're doing anything in racing. You learn a lot more from your failures than you do from when you have success. And, so you got to be willing to try and you got to be willing to fail. And just going along, it's taught me a lot. And from there, I've worked with a lot of customers from the past few years that I've had the business, and a lot of my customers have taught me things and been able to show me what they're doing at different tracks and what's working and what's not, and I can by what's not working for them, I can change things around and help them get going a little better. And
yeah,
when they do, that teaches me. So,
how widespread do you have customers? I mean, are they all over the state?
It's more than just a state. It's all over the Northeast. It's basically okay. It's generally sportsmen and modified.
Okay,
but everywhere. I mean, you name it. Down in Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Delaware, Vermont, Canada,
wow,
New York, everywhere.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You know, talk to us about last season, 2014, where you ran, how things went for you, how things ended up.
Well, we ran weekly at I-88 Speedway, Thunder Mountain Speedway, and Utica Rome Speedway, and then we also ran a little bit at Kutztown with the Speedsters, X-Track USA there, and ran the Short Track Super Series. And a lot of other special events. We had a great season. We had 8 wins. We topped our win total from last year at 7. So
okay,
made an improvement, and hopefully we can get 9 or better this year. But we ended up doing well overall with consistency too. We had third place in points at Utica Rome.
That's a tough field there.
Yeah, very tough. We're not too far off. Just need to make some improvements, and we'll be there. But, definitely like racing there. They have a great field of cars, a wide racetrack, a lot of fun.
They also moved to Hoosiers this season. Does that hurt you guys, help you guys? Does it not matter? What was your comment on their move to Hoosier?
I think last year when they were on American Racers there, I was one team that had an advantage of that because I was running on American Racers Friday and Saturday, and then just continuing to on Sunday. Whereas this year it's going to be more where the other guys are running Hoosiers all weekend, and I'm going to have to switch to them on Sunday and just adapt. So that may be a challenge for me. I'm not really sure at this point, but we'll see what happens.
Now, you had – I actually got to see you a couple times at a couple of Short Track Super Series events. And from what I remember seeing that beautiful 21 Olam's car. Is that a car that you guys run at every track all weekend, or is that a specials only car? Because I understand, I think you have a 33 ride as well.
Right. The Olam's 21 is owned by Charlie Davis, and it's kind of an open competition car. It's got a Ironhead small block in it. We've taken it to I-88 Speedway, Thunder Mountain. We've taken it to Utica Rome. It's competitive. It's competitive basically everywhere we take it. We won a race at Utica Rome last year. We won four events at Thunder Mountain and one at I-88 with it. And it's a workhorse car. We've been running it for years and years. There's a lot of old parts on it. But it's a newer style Troyer chassis that's been very good to us and won a lot of big events and a lot of regular events. And it's just very grateful for a friend of ours, local farmer named Charlie Davis, that just kind of used to have my dad drive for him, and I used to work on the car, and then when my dad quit racing, I jumped in it and took off from there, and he's just kind of let me hold the reins to the whole operation, let me take care of it, and do what we can with it, and we take the winnings from the races and put it back into the car and nice. Race some more. And just do it. Just get what we can out of it. Whereas, like, our 33 car, that's sponsored by Gevo's Rears and Gears.
And
we, with that car, we've got a big block in it to run at Utica Rome. And then we also have a spec head to run some of the, you know, the small block Super Dirt Series shows. And also runs very well. We had a feature win there at Utica Rome with that last year on opening night. And, you know, it got us, that got us to that third place points finish there throughout the season. You know, we're running the same chassis. Skip Seymour helping me out with an engine this year to go to Utica Rome. Got a little more power than we had last year, so that should help. Pretty excited about that.
Yeah. Looking back on last year, was there a night or, you know, certainly a win that was, man, that was probably our best night last year. Is there one of those you can think of from last year?
The fall 250 at I-88 was pretty exciting. The week before, we had had a run-in with another driver at Accord Speedway.
Okay.
And we were leading the event, got taken out. You know, weren't happy, very frustrated with the situation and everything. Came back that night at I-88, passed that other driver, ended up winning the race.
Wow.
On the last lap, passed Sean Walker for the lead. And, you know, an exciting finish like that means a lot to me. It was a higher-paying event. Okay. That was probably the highlight win of last season.
When you come back from that, you're frustrated because of the situation, and it gets you up on the wheel, you know?
Yeah, it definitely does. I think, you know, there's just a heightened level of ambition there, a little more motivation to just do whatever it takes to get to the front. Rather than sometimes you can have a little too much respect for everyone out there, and you don't want to be stepping on other people, and you kind of, you know, you want to get to the front, but you don't want to be having everybody mad at you after the season's over. I mean, or just after the night's over.
True.
There are some guys out there that aren't making any friends, you know. So you know, you gotta give and take a little bit.
It's a fine line, you know, trying to balance those two. So this season, are we looking at the same schedule? I-88, Thunder Mountain, and Utica Rome.
Yeah, very similar schedule. We got. We're gonna take Jimmy Shear's 77X car this year. That's also sponsored by Olam's and Bert Adams Disposal, Gagnon Surfaces. You know, they ERE Decker Real Estate. They're real close to Thunder Mountain Speedway. The shop's right down the road. We can run and grab something. It's just a better fit to have their team at Thunder. And then we're going to take the 21 Olam's car to I-88 Speedway.
Cool.
And we'll still have our Gevo's Rears and Gears 33 at Utica Rome. And then we're gonna have... right now we got everything set up to run the North Series, the Short Track Super Series with our equipment. And new ride this year is with Dave Zuwakowski and Zuby's racing team.
Oh, okay.
We're going to run a 21Z.
Oh.
It's a Higfab chassis. We're going to run at Orange County and Accord special events. And then any other special events that we can make it to that just fit into our schedule.
Wow. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, will the Gobbler that was left over, will that be one of them that you guys run with the Zuby's car?
Yeah, that'll be one of the first races with the Zuby car. But the first one that we're going to try it out in is the Hard Clay Open on the 7th of April.
Yeah.
That'll be the first test with it. It'll be cool. I think they got a good operation going there. They've been very nice to us. They went down there and Jerry got us fitted in the car, you know, adjusted the seat mounts for us.
Yeah.
And,
last call on the red ticket.
You know, they're very accommodating and helpful. So happy about that.
And not a bad deal to have the chassis manufacturer on the team as well. You know, that's a good deal there too.
Yeah, he's also driving for Zuby, as well as Jeff Strunk and Daryl Ford. And it's a great group of guys. You know, I like working with the guys. They're all very nice people. And we hung out at Atlantic City when they had the races down there. And, yeah. You know, when I'm down at the shop, they're very welcoming. So it's always fun in the racing business when everybody's, you know, fun to work with.
All right, man. Well, we're looking forward to seeing you there at the Hard Clay Open at Orange County and, you know, getting the race season started up. Anybody else that you'd like to thank before we end our time here?
I just want to thank everybody here at the party for coming out to support this team. And, you know, I'm just happy to be on your show, having a good time here, and, you know, we'll continue.
All right, man. Well, we'll talk to you soon. We'll see you out at Orange County for sure. And that's Mike Mahaney. He'll be driving 21Z. 33, and then the 21 car on occasion.
And a 77X.
And a 77X. Yeah. So be on the lookout for Mike Mahaney at I-88, Thunder Mountain, Accord. Hold on, let me get this right. The Zuby's car was for Accord Specials and...
And Orange County.
Orange County, that's right. So, and then, of course, the 33 at Utica Rome. So anywhere there's dirt modifieds, you're sure to see Mike Mahaney out there this year. And don't forget, you'll see Mike Mahaney racing shocks on the Nick Query 25G each and every week at Canandaigua Motorsports Park. We're going to step aside here for just a second. We've got more dirt track drivers going to join the show here from the Query Racing Benefit Party. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
WinYourNewCar.com. Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at WinYourNewCar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free. Come on, stop dreaming. Start driving with WinYourNewCar.com.
You hear that? That's the sound of America's only sports car. That's right, it's a Corvette. But not just any Corvette. It's your Corvette. It's that who cares if there's traffic part of your day. And this can be you when you come to Cooper Corvettes. With 60 years of Corvettes to choose from, there's always a Corvette in your budget. And they'll service any Corvette you bring in. Cooper Corvettes on Route 1 just north of Quantico and Triangle. Call, click, or visit CooperCorvettes.com.
Hi, this is Yen Scott from Summit Point Kart in Summit Point, West Virginia. If you're looking for a real racing experience on a real racetrack, come out to Summit Point Kart this weekend. For as little as $25, you can get your racing career started. New this year, Summit Point Kart offers the RX250 capable of over 75 miles an hour. We're open every Friday from 5 p.m. till 9 p.m., Saturday from noon till 10 p.m., and Sunday from noon till 9 p.m. For more information, go to our website, summitpointkartwithak.com, or you can call us at 304-725-5270. Summit Point Kart, your East Coast karting center.
In the race of everyday life, it's nice to have the green flag, but drivetrain problems are the pits. A fully remanufactured engine, transmission, or differential from Jasper Engines and Transmissions costs less than a new vehicle and comes with a 3-year, 100,000-mile nationwide transferable warranty. See JasperEngines.com for details and get the green flag in your race of everyday life.
See the boys at Chandler & Sons Automotive, 45977 Old Ox Road in Sterling. Give them a call, 703-437-7300.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ and photo booth of Turn 5 Live. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are sure to provide you with the very best DJ and photo booth entertainment on the market in the Finger Lakes. Call Stu at 315-481-9700 or creeksideentertainmentdj.com. Book your party or photo booth with Creekside Entertainment today.
Now back to the Larry Curley and Moe of Dirt Track Racing.
Big Poppy, Clint Miller.
Ho, 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 Steven.
Ho, 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 here at the poorhouse. Alongside to my left, we got B-Rad.
What's up?
Yeah, there we go.
He's going to have his hands full tonight, I'm afraid.
Everybody's feeling frisky tonight.
Steven, Clint, and Brad.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Query Racing Benefit Party here in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get to talk to a gentleman who carries the HICFAB banner at Canandaigua Motorsports Park, Eric Jaguar. Eric, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Let's talk about, I mean, man, you're a busy guy.
Yeah.
You're flying all over the country and then come home and go racing on the weekends.
Yeah, I spend a lot of time in the air, so it's been a hard balance the last couple of years, you know, being gone so much and then trying to do the racing. And the only reason why I'm able to race is because of Bruce Ridley and Brighton Nobart. They, you know, they do everything while I'm gone. They take care of everything. And so if it wasn't for them, I couldn't do any of this.
Now, I just actually today saw that the Hick Fab that you won at the auction is now been down the road. Tell us about that.
Yeah, it's kind of a long story. You know, I love my Hick Fab car. You know, we got it last year, went out, should have won the first race, but I ran over a tire and ended up winning the second race with it. And we really loved the car, and a lot of people helped us with it, get it going. And then at the end of last year, I sold everything for racing. I had to do it because the way we had the racing set up, I had to set up a little bit differently. And so we started fresh. We were going to buy, you know, run Hick Fab. That was the intentions. I bought the Hick Fab at the Parts Peddler. And then when the Bicknell went for sale, it was going to be cheaper for me to buy the Bicknell, take the parts off of it, sell the Bicknell cage and body,
okay,
and build the Hick Fab with that. That was my intentions. But then after I bought the Bicknell, it was already assembled. It was already together. It didn't require any work. And as busy as I am in the wintertime flying around, and, you know, my crew chief, he's got a baby coming now this summer. So it just made more sense for us to run the Bicknell because it's already put together.
Okay.
And, you know, unfortunately, a lot of people, you know, Jerry, he builds a great car. I love the Hick Fab car, and it's nothing against the Hick Fab chassis at all. I'd love to run the Hick. It's just what was easier for us at the time.
Sure.
So,
oh, that's understandable.
And actually, we sold the car. We dropped it off today, but we were going to, if it didn't go in the next week or two, we were going to start building it. We were going to start putting together with some stuff and have two cars, and I was going to try to run that at Brewerton and, you know, maybe on some of the grit stuff and then keep the Bicknell for Canandaigua.
Yeah.
So.
Talk to us about this year. There's so many awesome options for the sportsman guys that, I mean, everybody'd love to run everything, but you just not enough time in the day to do that. What is it? I mean, as busy as you are with your job, what does that look like for you this year?
Well, we're gonna try to run Canandaigua. I mean, Canandaigua's home. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
The girls, my daughters, love it there. Their uncle races there. Justin races there, and so, you know, we're definitely gonna, you know, run Canandaigua. I really want to run a lot of different other tracks. You know, we ran Brewerton a couple of times. We were pretty good there. And so I'd like to win in another track, run somewhere. You know, we're going to hit all the – Bruce loves Weedsport. We're going to run Weedsport. And, you know, all depending on if I'm in town when the races happen. But we're trying to build my work schedule around those. And, you know, we're gonna try to do some racing this year. You know, I told Renee that we're going to try to hit a lot of races and go at it this year, and I've always wanted to go to a lot of them. So, you know, I'm hoping to hit quite a few of them.
Weedsport, with the new clay they put down, did you get a chance to get on that?
I didn't run that. I ran the other race. I didn't get a chance to run the one with the new clay.
Gotcha. Massive improvements to that facility. I mean, it was definitely different seeing the stage come down. I mean, that was like... That was the icon for that place. But going forward, I mean, that is going to be a formidable racetrack in the area, you know? It's like we got a lot of positive momentum going right now.
Yeah, you know, I think Weedsport is I think Weedsport's going to help save dirt racing up here. You know, sometimes, you know, people think, oh, dirt tracks are run down. And it just, you know, them guys showed that you can have a classy facility, have great racing, a great place to entertain family and people, and they definitely have done it right there. I take my hats on. It's a big investment on their part, and but I think in return, they're definitely going to get the support. You know, the sportsman race, we had a good turnout, and you know, people are excited to go to places like that. And you know, I know it's hard, and you know, financially it's hard, but I hope other tracks, you know, follow and start to see, and we can, you know, have a big thing going up here.
Absolutely.
I have a love-hate relationship with Weedsport. You know,
okay.
I don't normally go very good there, and then my favorite race car I ever had, I killed it there that one night when I had that wreck, and so, but we did win pretty good there this year, so we're going to try to go there next year.
Good deal. Canandaigua. Jeremy puts his heart into that place, and it shows on a weekly basis. You guys have so much room to race there, and it doesn't matter what division it is. It's just, that's a great place to go watch a dirt track race.
Yeah, I mean, Canandaigua, Bruce yells at me, tells me I need to go race other places, but, you know, I mean, there's just something about Canandaigua. You know, I mean, it's fast.
I mean, the place is called Land of Legends, you know?
Yeah, and, you know, and I got to tell you, you know, when look at the big block class. You know, look at the names you got in there. You know, all the top guys are in there. You know, minus a couple, and then you start looking at the sportsmen, and you know, any night in the sportsman division, there's, you know, you're racing against maybe 15 track championships. You know, probably 60, 70 wins.
Exactly.
So it's you know, it's a tough division, and you know, it's racing, and you know, we go at it on the track, but everybody gets along for the most part, and we have a lot of fun. And so, and you know, Jeremy does a lot of hard work there. He's trying to make the place nice, and so I like going there. So we'd like to move them tires on the bottom of one and two, and coming out of four, but we'll work on that.
Sure. You got one win there last year.
Yeah.
2015. You know, just focusing on Canandaigua. What's gonna make, you know, what end result's gonna make that a success this season?
I need to win more races. So yeah. We my first year I won three races, and we won a lot of races. We won the track championship, and you know, just over the last 4 years, with, you know, my grandfather got sick, and you know, my daughters are getting older doing stuff, and my business is busy. We haven't really been able to give it a good go, you know what I mean? And so, you know, last year I was gone to softball, and I wouldn't trade those things for anything, but, you know, I'm normally a points racer, but I want to win some races, you know? So we're gonna go out, we're going to try to win some races, and you know, I told the guys I want four wins, you know? So
nice.
We'll see what happens. But, you know, at Canandaigua, one win is saying something, you know?
Yeah, I mean,
it's a tough group to race with, so...
Yeah.
But in the end, let's have some fun, right?
Oh, absolutely. That's what it, you know, if you can't have fun doing it, what's the point,
absolutely,
you know?
Absolutely.
So, I know it takes a hell of a crew and some marketing partners behind you to be able to do this thing and give you a chance to talk about those guys.
Yeah, no, we have Wayne Spa Service. He's he helps us out. He, you know, if you guys have a hot top out there or whatever, you know, you're looking for somebody to have something fixed, he does that. We have Heritage on our car now. They're an archery shop in Phelps, New York.
Okay.
Mike Price and Jen Price, they're awesome people. Our kids go there and shoot bows, and very, very family-oriented, very good with the people, so we put them on there. Mad Skins Bodies, 811, you know, Dig Safe New York. So, yeah, we're very lucky.
Good deal. Well, man, appreciate the time here. Go enjoy yourself, and it won't be too much longer, and hopefully this weather clears out and we'll be ready for cabin fever.
I hope so. We'll see what happens. Thank you.
All right. That's Eric Shiger. He drives the 67G weekly there at Canandaigua, and going to see him at a whole bunch of other different places this year. You're listening to Turn 5 Live on the Performance Motorsports Network.
How would you like to win a brand new Corvette? Larry O's got all the details.
Enter America's number one dream car giveaway contest at winyournewcar.com. That's right, winyournewcar.com. Complete the puzzle the fastest and win a new Corvette tax-free delivered to your door. Come on, stop dreaming and start driving with winyournewcar.com.
We're growing like crazy and need account reps who know their way around agencies, the internet, and social media. Got connections? Or do you know how to get to the decision makers? Are you fearless? We need you. Internet radio, or as we call it, wireless mobile radio, is rapidly becoming the place to be with almost limitless income potential. So contact us to get involved with the fastest growing professionally produced group of internet radio stations in the world. Your imagination is the only limit here. Call 717-749-0444. That's 717-749-0444. Or you can email us at scorpionradiogroup@gmail.com. You want to ask for Sue.
So you finally arrived at the sweet spot in your life. The kids are raised and gone. You have free time, and it's finally time to do something for you. If you've ever considered owning a Corvette but have been putting it off for years, now is the time to act. Isn't this the time to finally get that Corvette you always wanted and drooled and dreamed over? Well, grab the little lady by the hand and take her to Cooper Corvettes. They're conveniently located on Route 1 just off of I-95 and just north of the Marine Corps base. They have lots of pampered and well-maintained Corvettes in inventory, and if they don't have what you want, they'll find it. From classic Stingrays to modern-day cars, Cooper is your one-stop shop. And speaking of shops, they service what they sell. And even if you didn't buy a Cooper Corvette, they'll service your Corvette anyway. Become part of the Cooper Corvette family. Call them at 703-445-1483. That's 703-445-1483. And on the web at coopercorvettes.com. That's coopercorvettes.com, American pride and countrywide.
You wouldn't trust your taxes to an uncertified accountant. So why trust your vehicle to an uncertified technician? When you have to take your car into the shop, look for the blue and white ASE sign. That ASE blue seal means the shop employs technicians certified by the National Institute for Automotive Service Excellence. ASE certification is proof that technicians have the knowledge and experience to fix your vehicle right the first time. For more information on finding an ASE Blue Seal of Excellence facility, visit the website at www.ase.com.
Creekside Entertainment is the official DJ and photo booth of Turn 5 Live. Stuart Ovens and his staff at Creekside Entertainment are sure to provide you with the very best DJ and photo booth entertainment on the market in the Finger Lakes. Call Stu at 315-481-9700 or creeksideentertainmentdj.com. Book your party or photo booth with Creekside Entertainment today.
This is Jared, and you're listening to Turn 5 Live.
Welcome back, race fans, to Turn 5 Live here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Steve Ovens coming to you from the Gory Racing Back Row Gang Benefit Party here in Seneca Falls, New York. Now we're going to get to catch up with Big Block Modified driver Gary Tompkins. Haven't had you on the show in quite some time. No. Good to have you here.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Let's talk about 2014. How do we evaluate last season as we get ready to start 2015?
It started out like gangbusters. We won the Janmore Corcoran Memorial. Beginning of the year, we were really good, especially at Canandaigua. We were as good as anybody, and we ended up blowing up our really good motor, and everything went downhill from there. You really got to be on the ball on these things. And, the motor we had running after that wasn't quite up to par. We were giving up a little bit anyway, but then we gave up more. And then just after that, it was just, stupid stuff happening to us and mechanical breakdowns and stuff. We go to Syracuse and we were mid-pack, which we knew we were going to be because the track was fast. We went up there with a deal like we always do. We want to finish the race. Well, I made two laps, burnt a bunch of pistons. Still haven't figured out why. I almost think maybe got some bad gas or something. I don't know. We went to Brockville the following week, and we ran decent there, but the track rubbered up, and we didn't finish as well as we were running. We finished 11th, but we were probably, a top five car. Go to Eastern States, drive a 673 there. And again, qualified. Not really good. We took a little bit to get the car going, but we were fast. Had to run through the consies on Sunday, but we were fast and make two laps there, break a jack shaft and rear end. Holy cow, I've never done that before.
Yeah.
Get everything back together, go to Charlotte, and we just had, a bad weekend there. And had one DNF and then one, we ended up hurting the motor. So it just... end of the year was terrible for us, and the way you end the year sometimes carries over, and it's just tough to get going this year, finding help and stuff like that to get going for this year.
Yeah. So is that kind of where we're at right now for 15?
Well, right now we're working on our motor program, trying to figure out what's going on there, trying to get the motor fixed, and come up with funds to get it fixed. And, the car, I tried selling the frame, and there's so many cars out there that are in decent shape that they basically given away and I wasn't going to give it my car away. It's really in good shape. So I think we're just going to put that back together and then see what we can do about finding something to power it and go from there. If we can come up with a motor program, it's decent, I think we should be okay, but that's going to be the problem right now. And hopefully we can find something... it's going to be good because this deal, they pull this deal off at Rolling Wheels like they say they're going to. We run really well at that place for whatever reason.
And, sure.
There's definitely some money to be made there. So, hopefully we can figure something out there and get on the track and do some running at that place.
Now, as far as Rolling Wheels goes, I mean, what your sentiments are, it seems to be what I hear from everybody about that deal.
Yep.
Is, now... speaking as a veteran driver, are we going to get to opening night there before we really know what's going on? Or
I don't think it'd be opening night, but I think it's going to be pretty close to that for sure. I'm sure there's going to be that car show up in Syracuse. I would think they're going to have a presence there. You know, they would be smart to just to get the news out. You know, and more, you know, they've been having a presence on Facebook, but that's, you know, they're playing games with that. You know, it's not really telling us, the racers, you know, what's going to go on there. You know, how is, you know, we don't even know, you know, how many laps the events are and stuff like that, or the schedule, you know, the race schedule for each night, you know, how everything goes. So, you know, how qualifying goes and stuff like that. So, you know, it's just one of them wait and see deals. It's still got a little bit of time, you know.
Yeah.
You know, they have a schedule out there, but there's, you know, they say they're going to have a series race, but then they're, right now they got to have a series, they got to race up against the series race at Canandaigua. So it's like,
right.
But you can't do that, you know.
Right.
So you got to figure out something. But, you know, hopefully, you know, they pull it off, because, you know, I really like to see that place thrive. I think it's a great track. I think it's, if it's done right, I you know, I give credit to Dirt. They really tried to make it go of it, but I don't think they ran there enough. And, you know, they needed to spend some money on it. And hopefully this deal here will spend some money on the place.
Yeah.
Not only, you know, they need upgrades around the facility, you know, and stuff like that, but I hope they fix the track too. It needs a, you know, and we've all known this, needs a new surface, you know, and some stuff fixed there. So hopefully it comes up, you know, but it's one of the deals, it sounds really good. So
right, right.
I've been around long enough to know usually when it sounds really good, it's not, you know. So hopefully this is.
Yeah.
You know, we'll see what happens, but they say they're full steam ahead, so hopefully they are.
You talked about the surface there. It's been a while since it's had a resurface.
Yeah, it's been quite a few years, and, you know, especially, you know, you can't really see it from the stands or anything, but down at the other end, turn three and stuff like that, it's getting down to bare rocks and spots, and, you know, it's just getting to be where, you know, it's getting to be where it's not as raceable as it used to be. But the problem is, when they did purchase, I don't know who put the surface on it before, whatever surface they use, the material they use, is, had sand in it or something. That's why it's always dusty. It's nothing, you know, you can't water sand and not have it be dusty, you know, and, so I need to find some good material, and hopefully if they do, because I've been there when that place is good, and boy, it's fun to race at, you know, but it's not fun when it's dusty and you can't see, and you're going as fast as you go at that place, because you really go fast at that place.
Absolutely. You talk about, you know, the material for a track. Did you get a chance to get on the new surface at Weedsport?
I did not. I have not. I know, talking to some guys, you know, obviously it looks different, you know, because it's sort of reddish clay, which is sort of not usual for this area. But just talking to people, you know, it sounded like it was pretty slippery and stuff like that. But I think, you know, you put it on in the middle of the year and really, you know, you got to run it on a few times. So hopefully letting it sit and, you know, they're going to have some shows on there. I think they'll get it figured out, because that's one thing I know about Al Hanke is he really wants to make that thing go. So I think they're going to do whatever it takes to be successful there. I'm really thrilled for that. You know, I sort of grew up at that place. When Glenn first bought the track, my mom and dad worked for him. My dad ran the caution lights, and my mom worked concession stands. So I ran all over that place down there when I was a little kid. So I spent a lot of Sunday afternoons and Sunday nights there. So I really like to see that place, you know, go and be a success.
Wow. Now that's a little bit of history I wasn't aware of. You know, that's cool. I mean, you talk about, you know, rolling wheels if it happens, Weedsport. You know, I feel like your perspective is as good as anybody's. It seems like dirt racing in our area is healthier than it's been in a while.
Yeah, it is.
And I know there's still a level that we can keep going to, but as far as the last 5-10 years go, it seems like we've got more momentum than we've had in a while.
Yeah, I think, you know, when Glenn sold the, you know, dirt to Boundless, you know, I still remember the first meeting they had with us. You know, they called us, you know, Lead 11 or whatever it was they called us at that time.
Oh, yeah.
And we had that meeting in Syracuse, and they said to us, you know, this isn't going to be an evolution, it's going to be a revolution. And we all sort of looked at each other. At that time, you know, things were going really well. I mean, there was corporate sponsorship. You know, at that time, they were paying pretty good, and, you know, they're still paying what they're paying now, what they paid then, you know. So, and the costs weren't nearly as much as they are now. So, you know, and I think it really, the way they went about it, was all wrong at that time, and it lost a lot of trust, and it took a lot of long time for get that trust back. And I think they finally have. I think Dirt Car has done a good job of finally getting back to, you know, making it so they're reliable. They're going to be, they have rules. They're going to go by the rules. They're not going to mess around. They don't play favorites. Stuff like that, and try to make it so, we know when we go to a track that we're gonna put a show on, and we're not gonna really have to worry about, all this BS and stuff. We're just gonna go race. And that's all as a racer you want. You don't wanna have to deal with stuff, worry about, favoritism or like that, and even if the guy is an inept that's running the thing, these guys pretty much know what they're doing now. It's slowly come back, and hopefully the next step is going to be, get the pay up on some of this stuff. And, people want to change rules. Well, you change the rules, you're going to cost money to the racer. But, let's keep the rules sort of where they are, maybe a few small rule changes, but nothing big. But, they need to get sponsorship back in here and, package it so it trickles down to the racer and, gets in our pocket so we can spend money to get back to the racetrack.
Yeah. You were one of the guys that spoke up about, the positive things that Joe Skotnicki brought to the team as far as World Racing Group goes. Now they transition into Mike Perotti filling Skotnicki's role. For guys that you've talked to in the racing circles, he's had a few races down at Volusia. Yep. But also with past experience, knowing Mike, where do you think, is that? I mean, from guys we talk to, people feel like it's a good thing.
Yeah.
But what can you tell us about your experience with Mike?
Well, I've known Mike for a while. Actually, he tried running some of the series last year, but the Super Dirt Series, but he'd been away from it. So, he did struggle a little bit. And so I talked to him a few times. I've known him for a while. And personally, I don't, when Joe left, I was trying to think, man, who the heck can they get? And I was praying they weren't going to bring somebody in that didn't really know the Northeast dirt modified scene and, racing in general in the Northeast, because it's different than it is the rest of the country. It's a whole different deal. And I don't think they could have brought in a better guy than Mike. He's run a track. He's raced the division.
Yeah,
he knows pretty much everybody in the division.
Promoted,
Yeah, he's done it all. So I think they've done a great job of hiring the right guy to do it. And hopefully they let him do his job the way he sees fit. Not trying to make him a puppet. Because I think, if you look at Airborne Speedway where he promoted, he really built that place up and made it a success. And really, you look at the area, and there's not a whole lot in that area. And and he brought it to life, and he made it relevant. And hopefully, I talked to Matt and Justin a little bit tonight about that and how things went. And they were pretty happy with the way things went. And like I said, he just got his feet wet. But I think, like I said, if they let him do things the way that I think he wants it to be done, I think things will be good.
Well, I couldn't agree with you more there. I think that's a positive hire for them, and like you said, that's the key is letting the man do the job he's hired for. So.
Yep.
Well, man, it's good to catch up, man. Yep. It's good to talk racing here, and looking forward to seeing you out at the Canandaigua opener. And I mean, is that where what we're looking at for this year is Canandaigua? And
well. I mean, I'd love to run a series, but right now I don't know what's going to go on there. If I could do Canandaigua, and then, if Rolling Wheels is going to do what they're going to do, I'd love to run there and then run as much of the series as I can. I don't know how much traveling I'll do. I'm going to drive for Tom Kaur this year. I actually drove for him a little bit last year. He has a few cars. Brent Wilcox won the championship for him at Thunder Mountain, and Brian Malcolm drives for him too, so... they're going to pick up their new car for me to drive here in a couple weeks from Bicknell's and throw it together. And we still haven't really got a schedule to go yet, but it's going to be a bunch of specials down that area. It's going to have a small block in it. We ran a few races for them last year, and actually we had some good runs, just bad luck type deal,
Sure.
So look forward to running with them guys. I had a lot of fun last year, and hopefully we can have success there too.
Well, hopefully all the bad luck's in the rearview mirror. I think 2014 probably got your fill on that. So.
Yeah, definitely. It's it's racing. It is what it is. It makes you humble.
Yeah.
Sure. But I'm back at it. Hopefully we can get things straightened out and get to the racetrack.
All right. That's Gary Tompkins, driver of the 84 Big Block Modified. Looking forward to seeing him out here at Canandaigua and Rolling Wheels. And thank you for your time, man. Always good to catch up with you.
Yep, thanks for having me.
That's all that we've got from the Brewery Racing Benefit Party. I'm your host, Steve Ovens, saying goodnight, everybody. We'll see you next week here on Turn 5 Live.
Five Live is a copyrighted production of the Performance Motorsports Network. PerformanceMotorsportsNetwork.com is a member of the Scorpion Radio Group, Incorporated, and may not be rebroadcast, replicated, or saved in any media without the explicit written permission of PMN. The opinions expressed on this program are those of the host, co-host, and guest, and do not necessarily reflect those of the management and ownership of either the Performance Motorsports Network or Scorpion Radio Group, Incorporated, the advertisers, or marketing partners. Thank you for listening to Turn 5 Live. You can listen to Turn 5 Live every Tuesday night right here on the Performance Motorsports Network. Stay tuned for more great PMN programming.